Elementor version 2.1 just hit beta, and in this video I'm going to show you around some of the new features that Elementor just released. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button, and if you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell for notifications. There's a lot of goodies in Elementor version 2.1. There's stuff in there for developers, for every normal user. So in this video, I'll also show you how to get access to the beta version if that is what you want. So here we go. If you want access to any of the beta versions of Elementor, you would go to Elementor and then you would go right here to where it says tools, and then there's a tab here that says version control, and that's where right here where it says beta tester, you'd want to enable this. And then what will happen is if a beta version is available, it will be available there for you to upgrade to. All right, so let's go ahead and start talking about some of these changes. Now, most of these changes are going to be usability changes. So it's there, and that's one of the benefits of using a page builder on a mature platform. So Elementor is 2 years old, and now it's these usability refinements that are getting added. And that is what the focus is of this. But like I said, there is something for everyone. All right, so first of all, for developers and for mobile responsiveness, you can now set the custom breakpoints for the different devices. And to get to this, you would go to Elementor right here where it says settings, and then we would go here to advanced. Oops, style. So you can tell I haven't played around with this enough. Okay, so I'm on the style tab, and right here you see tablet breakpoint right here. And then right here you have mobile breakpoint. This is something that web developers have been asking for, and now Elementor has definitely delivered these custom breakpoints here for you. Now that is really the main thing that's in the back end. Everything is pretty much going to be in the front end of Elementor. So here I have an Elementor page where I'm already in the editor. And so there's a couple usability improvements. Of course, we can now collapse our modules like that. This is very nice. But where most of the changes are going to be is when you're interacting. Some things have changed. So before, we had the different ways of accessing the settings for a section or a column. They've changed. And now you just see these three. We've got the plus, and that's to insert a new section. And then we have the edit section and then an X. And have you noticed when I move my mouse cursor, it changes to this very noticeable plus sign that makes it easy to drag and drop. But where all of the goodies really are is with a contextual menu that they added. So I can right click here, and now we have this contextual menu that is going to give us a variety of options. So the first one is just to edit the section. This actually solves a big problem. There are times where sometimes it's hard to actually click on this. So now anywhere in a section, you can right click and then choose edit section, and it will jump you right on in there to start editing the section. I actually made a video about a week ago on a plugin that kind of made this easy, but now it looks like you might not need that plugin for that feature. It's now part of Elementor. Now let's go through some of the other options. We've got duplicate. So before there was a little icon there to duplicate. Now there's just an option in this right click menu. And there's this constant reminder of the keyboard shortcut for that as well. But here's where some of the goodies come in. You can copy, you can paste, you can paste the style, you can reset a style, you can save it as a template, and you can delete it all with clicking with a simple right click. So if you right click anywhere in the section, usually it's easy to get to if you go to the far left or the far right, those options will appear for a section. But you can also do these on columns. So the easiest way to for sure get it is on that column icon, right click. And now we have these same options, but yet this time it's for columns. And we also have these options for the various modules. So I can right click anywhere on any of the modules, and then it's, or the widgets, which essentially mean the same thing, but we've got an edit widget, duplicate, copy, paste, reset, and delete. So essentially the beauty of this is, so for example, we've got this grid here, and say in this first part of the grid, I'm tweaking it to kind of make it just right, this style. And so maybe on the title here, I'd click on it, and as I'm experimenting, I might kind of change the color a little bit, and I might add some other kind of flair to it, like maybe add a text shadow. I probably wouldn't do that, but maybe I'd want to do that. Well, what you can do now, instead of manually setting the color for each one of these and manually adding that text shadow, you can just right click and you can click on copy, and you can right click and then you can just paste the style. And just paste the style and just paste the style. So that is one of the nice things here, is it's just a big speed builder when you can easily do it this way. But that's not all you can do. You can actually copy and paste across pages. So right here, I have an entirely different page right here. So let's go ahead and do some copy and paste here. So if I wanted to right click here, I can paste my style there if I wanted to. So you see, it's not just on the page that you're on. It can be across pages, and that is pretty huge if you ask me. Now, you can also copy and paste entire sections across. So right here, I might want to right click, and I'm going to click on copy, and then I'm going to go here and I'll right click and I'm going to paste just like this. And here it is. Here's my section. It just added it there. I can just click here and I can go right here and just drag it up a little bit if that's where I wanted it. And that's all there is to it. You can easily copy and paste styles and copy and paste modules. You can copy and paste sections. You can copy and paste columns. There's just no limit to what you can copy and paste. Now, there's also some additional options here. I can right click and you can see right here it says reset style. I can't tell you how many times I will use a widget and I'm starting to style it and I don't like at all what I've done and I just want to reset the style. Well, now you can click right here and it just resets the style exactly how it was. Let me just do a quick copy and paste right here. And I got it back to that. So you see how powerful and useful some of these features are. Now there's also a couple other little goodies here that I want to touch. There's some improvements to the video module. So right now, if I drag and drop a video in, first off, we have the different options here. We now have a daily motion and we have self-hosted. There's a new YouTube setting, and that's right here where it says modest branding. So essentially without the modest branding, let me show you that first. You see, okay, so this is without modest branding, and then let's turn modest branding on and go like this. And so essentially that YouTube logo that was right here on the bottom right, that is now gone. So that's what this modest branding is going to do. Let me show you the way it looked before. There it says YouTube. So you are now able to enable this as well. But there's also a couple other little goodies in here. You can specify the start time of a video and the end time of a video. So say you're using one of your videos and you only want when someone pushes play to be able to hit a section of that video. Well, now you can specify that start time and that end time. And of course, now you've got self-hosted videos right here. You can put in HTML5 based videos. And you still have those same options here of start time and end time. There are also a couple of other goodies like CSS filters. There's some CLI commands, new WP CLI commands. This is quite a feature release, and everything I just showed you is in the free version of Elementor. They also have a beta coming out soon of the pro version of Elementor. I don't know what goodies are going to be in there. It's definitely a lot to be looking forward to and excited about. So anyways, that's all that I have for you in this video. If you've enjoyed it, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Consider subscribing if you're not a subscriber. Let me know what you think about Elementor version 2.1 in the comment section below. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.